that it's a well-known phenomenon across the whole world that the healthcare cost is becoming increasing every year in an exponential manner. So it's a key initiative and key step that governments start being engaged on granting access, which is the core essence of the health, mandatory health insurance in the region, specifically in the UAE. When we look at the UAE, specifically UAE, compared to the other GCC regions, equally to Qatar, that the healthcare cost is maybe progressing in a faster pace than others. So that is one of the reasons healthcare insurance was extremely required to make sure that all the population in need are getting equal access and fair access to healthcare. I don't want to confine only the health insurance in terms of pushing out the financial risk outside the governments, because again, it's our role as private sector to help the governments deliver the purpose, and the core mission is granting access. So I believe that this is a very important step, and we are expecting it to be dynamically evolving and developing in the region as well. One of the most effective ways to ensure that all your population are getting access to health is making it compulsory to insurers, to employers, to get their employees enrolled in healthcare insurance. Because otherwise, it won't work, because we are facing some difficulties in the market that the level of maturity in terms of cultural mindset about healthcare insurance is not equal across all parties. So to ensure that everyone is engaged in the program, you need sometimes to enforce by law that people are taking the accountability of ensuring that their employees having access to healthcare. So I believe that even by time, you might see that people will run after healthcare insurance without mandates, but at the initiation of the law, it has to be in this way. Otherwise, the penetration of insurance is going to remain very low. As I mentioned, is first and above all is the insurance culture in the market needs to be well developed, and this needs engagement from all concerned parties in the circle of healthcare. So it's not only about regulator enforcing, it's about healthcare insurer as well doing their job in terms of marketing and branding the new laws. Employers doing their part in terms of encouraging their people to get involved in healthcare. So one is the penetration that is related to the healthcare insurance culture. The second element is the inflation of the market. And the inflation of the market needs to be addressed by all concerned parties, starting from pharmaceuticals, providers, and healthcare insurers as well. Because granting access is one part of the formula, and the other part of the formula is sustaining this access. And sustainability of the access is directly related to healthcare cost. See, so if I continue being managing claims rather than underwriting properly, premiums are going to inflate over time and people will get more difficulties in terms of accessing healthcare. So the other challenge is the healthcare inflation. The third challenge is that the fraudulent behaviors, either member fraud or provider fraud, that yes, we have some regulations, laws are there to regulate and to sanction the fraudulent behaviors, yet the level of engagement across all players is not at the same level of maturity. We know that it has just started now, but we need to emphasize more focus in the future on controlling fraud and waste and abuse, because this is going to add burden on the healthcare cost and hence making it difficult for users to access healthcare efficiently. Fourth is the supply-demand imbalance, which means that the demand is very high, yet the level of supply is not at the same level of the demand. And the structure of the infrastructure of healthcare is more catered towards acute conditions, yet we are moving steadily towards the chronic age conditions. So we need, in parallel of the enforcements of the law, to look into a reform of the healthcare infrastructure to make the supply and demand in equilibrium status. The most important thing is that we need to work together. As all stakeholders, they need to work together. So law is not only the responsibility of the regulator. And our mission as an insurer, as well as providers, as well as pharmaceuticals, that we need to sit around a table and start addressing the challenges of the market one by one. The key point is that it shall be transformed into a win-win situation for everyone, including the regulator and, of course, eventually the end user. So it's not a solo play. Today, everyone is working in his field looking at his own benefit. But I believe that there would be a common area of interest that would make us all sit down together and addressing the risk in the market. So my recommendation, my single recommendation, is that we need to have a panel of experts across all sorts of industries taking care of the healthcare insurance to sit together and agree on the way forward and addressing the challenges one by one. It's extremely important because actually if you are going to standardize the practices among let me say the top of the hierarchy in terms of the strategy teams across all areas of interest in the healthcare insurance without engaging the healthcare professionals who are actually executing what you are designing at a higher level, you are not going to get any gain. And the core essence of the success that you need to build your strategy forward from bottom up, not from top bottom. And I'm not saying here that bottom is mean that the lower rank, but at least healthcare professionals in the market, they are driving the whole set of practices in the market. So if you don't get your engagement, their commitment, and their inputs in the way you are designing forward the healthcare insurance future, you are risking the execution part to be weak. We need to understand that, again, it's not the GCC phenomenon only, it's a worldwide phenomenon that medication contribute to a significant percentage of healthcare costs. And despite of the regulations that have been done in the UAE in terms of electronically managing the appropriateness of medications, we need to get the right brains and the right skills across the board. And again, the most involved parties in this circle of interest are the pharmacists and the practitioners. In terms of awareness about the theory of medications, in terms of understanding and putting their insights about the economy, the pharmacoeconomics that might drive the premium up or down, or that might make difficult for the user to access healthcare or no, and to listen from them about their future visions. It's without this important step, you cannot get commitments from everyone. Again, it's related to designing the future shall involve the ground players and the executors rather than only the strategic thinkers.